I've already made a video a long time ago, which is part of the binary exploitation course, where I talked a little bit about signed and unsigned integers. And I just wanted to give a little bit more context for the video where we abuse an integer overflow to kill Magmarok in Pwned Venture 3. So let's say you debug an application and there is a 32-bit register and you see hex 44434241. What does it mean? As you know, hex values are super cool to represent binary values because 4 bit correspond to one hex digit, so there's a really nice 4-to-1 match, which makes it super clear. Anyway, if the binary value is just converted to decimal, it's 1.1 billion. But you could also say, no, I want to interpret this byte by byte as ASCII text, for example, if opened in Notepad. Then it would be the text ABCD. So there's interpretation going on. For the CPU, it's just bits, but based on the context where this value is used in, it could have different meanings. And that's the same way with negative numbers. As you may know, a negative 1 minus 1 would be in hex FFFFFF, or all bits set to 1, which might feel weird, but it has an awesome property. Actually, we abuse here an integer overflow in a useful way. You see, if we would like to calculate 3 minus 1 or rewrite as 3 plus minus 1, 3 plus negative 1, then you could calculate 3 plus hex FFFFF. And you would think that doesn't make sense because in decimal that would be a super huge value, so the result would be even larger. But because we are confined to 32-bit in this example, the result would require 33-bit, and thus we lose the first bit. The result kind of wraps around and we end up with 2. So we did indeed calculate 3 minus 1, and that's the awesome property of it. And because a binary number can be interpreted in the signed and unsigned way, especially for things like comparisons, the CPU has to have ways to understand this context. And this is why we have instructions that specifically are used if the data is signed or unsigned. And if you just search for signed in the official Intel architecture manual, you see loads of instructions that have signed and unsigned versions. And of course, this can lead to security issues when such an overflow was not intended. For example, when we want to add 3 billion plus 3 billion, then it doesn't fit in 32-bit and overflow. If we continue to use the result for anything important, then that's really bad. So that's why it's so important to be very careful when mixing signed and unsigned values, but also the numbers don't grow too big or too small and they overflow. And in the Magmarok video, you can see how there are two issues related to that.